If your baby is going to die, and it doesn't have to, it shouldn't matter how much money you make. I think that's something that, whether you're a Republican or a Democrat or something else, we all agree on that, right? I mean, we do.
There is still a lot of reaction to that monologue from Jimmy Kimmel the other night, talking about his newborn son's medical emergency. Charlie Hurt is making the case that Kimmel was using his son as a political prop. Listen to this with Martha last night.
This is very, very harsh, sure, given what this family went through.
Sure, but so is taking your ill child and inserting that child into the public arena and using them as a prop to push partisan political politics. I find that to be disgusting personally.
Kristen Soltis Anderson, Washington Examiner columnist, Republican pollster, and author of the book, The Selfie Vote. Leslie Marshall, syndicated radio host and a Fox News contributor who has had her own real life experience, similar. Ladies, good morning to both of you. Kristen, I think it's very important to point out the sensitive nature of this story, because you're left feeling as if there are politicians or even doctors who would not care for an infant in the state that Jimmy Kimmel's son Billy was in. Now, how do you see this and the criticism that's coming from Charlie Hurt?
So I don't have any criticism for Jimmy Kimmel, for someone who is a father who has gone through absolute torture over the last few weeks, having a platform and wanting to advocate to try to make sure that no parent has to go through anything even worse. I took away from Kimmel's comments actually something far less partisan. He says in that clip that you just showed that he thinks Republicans and Democrats can agree that we don't want any children to face this issue. Further in the monologue, he talks about how the budget that was just passed in Congress increased funding for the National Institutes of Health. So I didn't take from it nearly as much of a partisan message as I think Charlie Hurt did. Now, I would probably disagree with Democrats. I certainly would disagree with Democrats, might even disagree with Jimmy Kimmel on the best way to make sure that a child can receive that care, to make sure we have a healthcare system that provides top-notch care. But I did not take away from that Jimmy Kimmel was using his child as a prop in any way.
Leslie, how did you hear it the other night?
Well, I would agree with Kristen on that. What I heard was an individual who was putting aside who he was as a comedian and that he was a father who was lucky to have a happy ending. And as you know, I did not. I had a child that died from a terminal illness in 2004. My son, who would have been a pre-existing condition individual, and at that time in 2004 would not have been able to obtain insurance. And when the audience clapped, it was after the remark that whether you're Democrat or Republican, that's something we can both agree on. And that's something, Bill, that the polls show America agrees on. And quite frankly, why it's been so difficult for a repeal and replace by Republicans of Obamacare, because there have been a lot of moderate Republicans, even today as we speak, who are very concerned about their constituents who may have a pre-existing condition, or like me, who I was not so fortunate with my son, or Jimmy Kimmel's son, who were born with a pre-existing condition. I didn't think it was divisive. I didn't think it was partisan. And he's a comedian. I don't think he was going to sway anybody in that audience or watching that television, that program,
okay,
either way.
Got it. And Leslie, I want to be sensitive to your personal situation, too. And this debate's going to continue. But there's other late night news, and that's cool. Bear, and apparently he came out to apologize, but there was no apology. But I don't even know if he really came out to apologize last night. He didn't take anything back. Here's what the Boston Herald wrote. Liberals support political correctness and all its censorship-loving manifestations, but when it comes to attacking a sitting Republican president, Donald Trump, they dive headfirst into the gutter. It's no wonder America, particularly the flyover states, ignored the continuous loop of attacks and negative Trump coverage from Hollywood and the mainstream media during the campaign. End quote. Adriana Cohen, Boston Herald today. What Colbert said last night, Kristen, is that the president was insulting a friend of his. That friend was John Dickerson, a colleague who apparently had some incredible access to the president over the weekend, flew on board Air Force One, had at least a 30-minute sit-down interview, and then they went into the Oval Office, and at that point, you see President Trump ending the interview on this topic of wiretapping. Is he being honest with his audience and the way he evaluates his reaction to his quote-unquote friend, given the amount of time that he was given this past weekend?
You know, it would actually surprise me if the criticism of Colbert had only come from the right. I doubt that you would have seen any kind of apology. I think the reason why he came out and half apologized for what he said is because he was getting criticism on the left for saying things that were deemed to be homophobic, that actually were deemed to be politically incorrect by folks from the side of the political spectrum that I think he's more interested in catering to. Look, I don't think he should be fired unless his ratings tank and his network thinks that he doesn't have a good audience anymore.
Well, his ratings are going higher.
Well, and I think he's trying to figure out, okay, he had this very popular show on cable news where he was very, very brutal about Republicans, but made people laugh. Now he's on a network in a with a much bigger stage. Can he hang on to that audience while being extremely partisan?
Leslie, if you reverse the roles here and this criticism was aimed at Barack Obama, you think they could get away with that? Conservatives?
Oh, absolutely. You know, before I came on today, Bill,
to say something like that on network television in prime time, it's never we haven't really gone there before.
Well, I would agree that I think they call it in comedy going blue when you go a bit too far. But again, one of the things that's great about our nation, and there are so many, is our freedom of speech, our freedom to take that remote and click off or change a channel. And we do have that freedom, and so does the network to keep Stephen or to let him go.
Okay.
I think presidents, and I know presidents, have been made fun of. I would agree it was more the homophobic remark as opposed to saying something negative about the president. We should honor the person in it.
Comedy stage on Saturday night, I'm all for it, okay? I mean, you can say what you want. But on network television, I mean, some believe we have crossed a new line. We'll see if that's the case. Leslie, thank you for your time today. Kristen, thanks to you as well.
Thank you, guys.